Hello all, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install MinGW compiler for C and C++ programming on a Windows operating system. And then I am also going to show you how you can easily write a simple C program and how you can easily compile that on our MinGW compiler and how you can easily run that program on our console. So let's begin. So to install MinGW compiler, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser. And in that this bar, you need to just simply search with MinGW compiler download and hit enter. And you will get the sourceforge.net as our first search result. So here you can see we have MinGW minimalistic GNU for Windows download. So just simply click on that and it's going to redirect to the official site of sourceforge.net. So here if you scroll down, you can see that we have MinGW minimalistic GNU for Windows available to download. So here is our download button. So just simply click on that and it's going to, you know, after 5 seconds, going to start downloading our MinGW. So you can see it has rightly downloaded over here. So let's click on this installer. And you can see that our MinGW installation wizard rightly open. So let's minimize our browser. And here you need to just simply click on install. So, you know, it's going to install on this installation directory called MinGW folder they're going to create basically. If you want to change this installation location, you can do that by just simply clicking on this button change, or else you can keep this default. And you can just simply click on continue. And it's going to, you know, start downloading our MinGW. So the thing is, you need to have active internet connection for this. So you can see that it has, you know, it is going to download some of the packages and it's going to, you know, show you what all you need to install. So let's wait for a couple of minutes. So once it, you know, gets complete, you can see that we have this continue button now. So you can just simply click on continue and it's going to show you this installation manager window. So in here, you need to, you know, check this. So it will open this mark for installation. So you simply select that and you need to just keep on doing the same procedure for each and every item. So, you know, keep on doing mark for installation for this compiler as well. Right. So once you, you know, done with all these, you just simply go to installation and click on apply changes. And when you select that, it will going to show you this scheduler pending action. Just simply click on apply and it's going to start downloading our files. So again, you need to have active internet connection in order to, you know, complete this installation. So it's going to, you know, fetch all the packages and all, and then it's going to start installing our MinGW. So this will take, you know, some significant amount of time depending upon your internet speed. So once it gets completed, I'll be again coming back to this video. Yep. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that, you know, all changes were applied successfully is rightly shown. So you can just simply close this dialog now. And so our MinGW is rightly installed. You can also minimize this. Here you can see the installer. So let's go to our C drive. And you can see here we have this MinGW compiler. So just simply go inside that folder. You will see this bin folder. So just simply go inside that bin folder. And all you need to do is you need to click on this address bar, then right click and click on copy. Right. Now you need to click on this magnify icon. So you need to just simply search it in Viron. And you'll get this edit the system environment variables. So just simply open that. And in system properties, you need to click on environment variables. And here under system variables, you need to click on path. And then you need to click on edit. And now you need to just simply click on new. And then right click over here and paste. That's all. Now just simply click on OK. Then again OK. And then again OK. And now if you just simply again minimize this. And just simply open the command prompt, like simply type cmd, it will going to show you cmd over here. Just simply open the command prompt, and here if you just simply type g++ space dash dash version and just simply hit enter, you can see that our latest version of G++, which is version 6.3.01, is rightly shown over here. So if you get this similar type of prompt on your command prompt, all that basically means is our MinGW compiler is rightly installed. So let's create a new folder and cprac. I'll give the folder name, and I'm going to just simply going to create a new text document, and I'm going to name it as hello, and I'm going to change this .txt extension with .c, right? Just simply click on yes to change the extension. And now if we just simply open this file in Notepad++, so in my previous videos I have already shown you how you can install Notepad++, so you can follow that video. So here I'm going to write a simple C program. So hash include stdio.h int main, and I'm going to simply print hello world over here. Okay. So I need to return something. I'll return 0. Right. So just simply going to save this program. I'll minimize this. I'll just simply go to the folder where I have written this file. So I'll just simply go to this address bar, and I'm going to just simply type cmd over here and hit enter. It will open this command prompt window. So here I'll just simply type gcc and then the file name, which is hello.c. So hello.c, I'll just simply hit enter. And you can see it has rightly compiled with no error. So if the program has no error, then it will successfully going to create a a.exe file. So this a is basically, is the file which gets generated once our program gets successfully built. So in order to run that file, you need to just simply type a and hit enter. And you can see the output hello world rightly shown over here, right? So in this way, I can easily install MinGW compiler on a Windows operating system. I have also shown you how you can easily write a simple hello world program on C and how you can easily run that on our console. So that's all for this video. If you like the video, please give it a like and do subscribe our channel. That will really help me to make more such videos. So thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.